Hi everyone, Tina Killerin here. Thanks so much for joining me today for this Tasty Tuesday here in the Killerin Kitchen. Okay, so today's recipe, really, really simple. So what do I always suggest that a lot of you guys do over the weekend is to spend a little bit of time meal prepping. And when we say meal prepping, most of us cook up, whether it's grilling or roasting or putting it into a pan, is chicken. And how tired of you are you of taking that chicken and just slicing it up and throwing it over a green salad every day for lunch? Gets a little boring after a while, don't you think? I'd say so. So over the next couple of days, I'm gonna give you some different suggestions on what you can do with that cooked chicken that you've already meal prepped. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep those recipes really simple and really easy to do. So this way, when you're short on time during the week, you've already got that chicken already prepped and cooked, sitting in the fridge, and you're ready to go. Okay, so today's recipe is really simply a chicken, black bean, and avocado bowl. Now, there's a couple of variations that you can do with this as well. I'm gonna talk about that once we kind of set up our base mixture. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take two chicken breasts, rough chop them up. You don't have to be finely chopped or anything like that, but remember, it's already cooked. You've already grilled it, roasted it, sauteed it, boiled it. Doesn't matter how you've prepped it. You've got about two chicken breasts already cut up and put in there. Here's my black beans. One can of black beans drained and rinsed. Got it so far, right? Easy breezy. One avocado. Okay, just again, rough chop on that avocado. I tend to like my avocados a little bit softer, totally up to you on how you wanna make your avocado, right? If you need to let it sit a little bit longer. Last ingredient, one cup of salsa. Your salsa is really your choice. You can make it homemade, good for you if you're doing that. I'm a jar bought kind of girl, and I'm a medium flavored kind of girl. Yes, you do rinse the black beans, Cherish, because the black beans have that like gunky, skunky stuff on it. So I rinse all of my beans, especially when they're canned beans. I will rinse all of my beans all the time. So your salsa, medium salsa for us, just because Montana doesn't like things overly spicy. But if you're a hot salsa kind of person, by all means, feel free to use that hot salsa. And then a little bit of ground black pepper and just a pinch of pink Himalayan sea salt. That's it, just a pinch, because you've got all of the flavors coming in from the salsa, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead, I'm gonna give that a good stir here. Could it be any easier? I don't think so. I mean, really, it's the most simple thing in the world. Now, it might not look the prettiest thing in the world, but I'm telling you, it is absolutely delicious. Okay, so after giving it a quick stir, there you go. There's your four ingredients plus your salt and pepper in there. Your chopped chicken, your avocado, your black beans, and your salsa. Just mix that up, go ahead, throw that in a bowl. You can eat it just like that. I'm gonna say that what I made here is probably about four servings or so. So you can go ahead, divide that up into a bowl, and you can eat it just like that. It's perfect. It's got your protein, it's got your carbohydrates from those beans, and it's got the healthy fats from the avocados. Here's a couple of variations for you too. If you're looking to add a little bit more grains to your diet, you can always take some prepared, cooked quinoa or rice, and you can mix those in there as well. Or you can actually really put this into a tortilla or a lettuce wrap. You can add a little bit of sour cream, or better yet, some green. So you can go ahead and you can just add this mixture to a tortilla if you'd like, add some sour cream, or better yet, some Greek yogurt, and sprinkle a little bit of cheddar cheese or Monterey Jack cheese on there. Now, you can eat this cold. If you want it warmed, I would go ahead and warm your chicken before you go ahead and add all of those other ingredients to it. I'm not a huge fan about warm avocado. I like my avocado a little bit chillier. So go ahead, give that recipe a shot. Like I said, you can make different variations too. Oh, and here's the thing. If you are really into those green salads, I get it. It's an easy way to get all those vegetables in on a daily basis. You can go ahead and you can throw this on top of your green salad. It's a great way to kind of season up and spice up that chicken rather than just having that plain old chicken on top of your green salad. Okay, so do me a favor, comment below. Let me know if you're willing to give this recipe a shot. Don't worry about if you didn't write it all down. I'm going to post up the blog here in a little bit later on for you guys. So this way you can follow along with the video or you can read the blog. Again, simple, easy to do, great things to do with that plain, boring chicken that you've already prepped and cut up for the week. So go ahead, give it a shot. Let me know what you think. Hope you guys all have a great day. Thanks for joining me here in the Killerin Kitchen today for Tasty Tuesday, and I will see you all on the flip side.